although appearing similar on the surface and at first glance, the Xingjian sidekick is very different. In comparison, most other styles use a torquing out of the knee when doing the sidekick. Another distinct difference of the Xingjian sidekick is its proximity to the target, a very close range within a sort of a foot or so between the leg and the target. Another distinct difference with the Xingjian sidekick is the way that its power source generates from the abdominal muscles. Here in this series of steels, it is shown how power is generated in most sidekicks. This way of doing a sidekick stresses the knee and limits the power. The most important part of the Xingjian sidekick is learning how to compress and prepare the kick with the abdominal muscles.
Point that leg out there. We're more focused on the setup, which would be coming up, burning that leg out.
It's good training for your mind to be silly around your friends, because if you go to combat, you make noise whenever you want to. You see what I'm saying? If you're shy about it here, you're going to be harder to make it happen under stress, you know? There! It changed everything. And your smile. See the is my smiling? It goes with it? All that? Beautiful. One thing I want you to change earlier, watch your cheat step, the one cheat step we put in to hide it, to set it up. If you need to, okay? Because you're going to train. Now we're going to train that muscle. Now we understand the motion, and what's going on. You understand what we're trying to get to, right? Mm-hmm. So now what we're going to do is we're going to compress the power here and release it on a straight line. Matter of fact, if you can get the pad, Jose. Oh yeah, maybe one there. Okay, yeah, get a pad if you need to. That's fine. You can sit on the pad. Yeah. Wrong side. Yeah, change sides. You have the right hand or left hand side? You have the right. Okay. Yeah, put that one in the right hand. And then, so what we're going to do, so everybody can learn this muscle. You got the angle, you got the sitting on the wall, you got to learn how to turn the hips, right? You got then you got the motion kicking, you got all these separate drills. I do them separately, like this one here. Now we want to say, because it's hard to hold your body weight and do all these movements and develop. You got the angle, you got the sitting on the wall, you got to learn how to turn the hips, right? You got then you got the motion kicking, you got all these separate drills. I do them separately, like this one here. Now we want to say, because it's hard to hold your body weight and do all these movements and develop the crunch sit-up power at the same time. So now hold your hand toward the target. Now the rule we use is the right, point the right hand in the training toward the target. That's going to tell you where you're going to go. Now you do the crunch sit-up. It's going to be as hard as the crunch sit-up, so it could kick your ass a little bit, like crunch sit-ups. We've done those, right? Edge of heels. So this prepares the weapon. This cocks it back up, gets ready. Target ready, sir. And then, so a little higher for him. He's gonna be about here. Yeah, a little closer. And you don't want to get your elbows locked out either. Because you're going to take the force. You're going to take force right about there. You can put two hands on it if you wish. And kick. Here. Yeah, now see how you walk outstretched. So now we get to find a way to study one specific line. All right, so crunch and shoot. All right, ready to get closer. Crunch, shoot, pop. Right, punch, so now, the more you crunch sit-up, the more power is going to develop in your weapon, because that weapon's a spring for the crunch sit-up. So the more crunch sit-up you get, the more juice you get. Okay, ready? Pop. And shoot, pop, shoot. Oh, hop, shoot. Bring it closer. Right, yeah, crunch, kick. See, it's a little closer than you would think of a sidekick, right? It turns, kick. Let's see how I'm changing his angle a little bit, because he's trying to come up foot around it. So I'm making him come right into that, the most painful part of your crunch sit-up, which is right there, probably, right? Kick. There you go. Feel the kick? Feel the sound? Kick, pop. A little hot closer. Pop.
Pop. Oh, grabbing up my ass.
Yeah. Grabbing up the ass muscle. That's a good one. Play the target. Okay, crunch in, cut, kick, pop. Don't turn your anus towards the target. No, you keep it right in the bone, pop, shoot. To make this work, a little fine kind of definition, kick, pop, cut, pop, kick. Now turn out a little bit, rotate this a little bit out, pop. That's it, kick, pop. Good, kick, pop. Good, kick, pop. Now do crunch sit up, go pop, pop. Make your hand touch my hand here. More of a crunch sit up. Make your knee touch my hand. Pop, kick, pop, kick. See how I do this drill? You guys remember this drill, it'll be on camera too, but this one here, see I'm making him do a crunch sit up, right? Pop, kick, pop, kick, pop, kick. Pop, yeah, you kick. And you kick out, you almost need a few more, you're done.
That's crappy.
See, I told you'd be happy with that, crappy. Are you ready?
Yeah,
All right. As you kick, watch me, rotate the leg just a little bit, okay?
Rotate it out
this way, a little bit, a little tiny bit more for you. Yeah, you're kicking a little bit up still. I want you to kick a little hair down. There's a toe point down a little bit, okay? Pop, kick. Pop, kick, pop, kick.
Come on a little.
Yeah, kick, pop, kick, pop, kick, pop, kick, pop. That's it, kick, pop. Feel the crunch sit-up? It kicked your ass, isn't it? Good, huh? That's good. You got it, yeah. That's the power that goes into the other guy's body. Develop the crunch sit-up power at the same time. So now hold your hand toward the target. Now with the rule is the right, point the right hand and then. Training toward the target. That's going to tell you where you're going to go. Now you do the crunch setup. It's going to be as hard as the crunch setup, so it could kick your ass a little bit. Sit-ups. We've done those, right? Edge of heels. So now, so this prepares the weapon. This cocks it back up, gets ready to go, and you get the target ready, sir. And then, so a little higher for him. He's going to be about here. Yeah, a little closer. And you don't want your elbows locked out either, because you're going to take the force. You're going to take force right about there. You can just put two hands on it if you wish. And kick. Here. Yeah, now see how you walk outstretched. So now we what we'll do, maybe if you guys watch some of it and went through it. You have to advance. That actually is pretty damn close. That actually is good. We're getting kind of close into that. You're not really going to be on camera. Especially when I cut it in at all, Jose, so I wouldn't worry about it. Just hang. I don't even see you right now on the camera. Good, actually. So if I stand here, and I'll get him to do like five kicks on it, see where he is. Then you want to launch toward the target and then compress the muscles from the right foot forward position. And then you're going to turn the foot as you step up, and then if the target's about this distance here. Ready? Launch out. Yeah. Now, what I used to do is I would come up like with a metatarsal like this. Instead of putting the foot flat, then you got to move. It's quicker if you put the kind of the edge of the foot, so that way it activate those muscles and the bones in the feet. So it goes like this. Kapoom. Boom. And then up. And pull it across. Body when you're ready. Oh, that's pretty close. You see the power of it? You see that time, but you still aren't perfect. You see how it lost the power this way a little bit? The more you compress it into one line, straight that way, if you can figure out how to do that, that's the most powerful way of doing it. Pop, go ahead. Yeah, close. That's pretty close, huh? Yeah, you have to turn the hips and compress at the same time, huh? Hide, and then jump and hit. Almost, it's still wobbled there. You're getting used to it, though. This is so, I've taken out boxers with this, because the boxers especially will start, you know, when they've gone hard on me, and somebody tries to hurt me like years ago, and I've taken them out, because they tend to be a little bit forward. And they're fighting, and then I would boom right in their body. He just dropped them. Really a good kick. Press.
Oh, I missed it.
Yeah, do like five more, and then we'll give Richie a chance. Now, right now, we're only working on the strong leg initially, so we'll have to. That's right. You're learning. You're learning. You're getting the idea.
It's frustrating not to be able to hate it.
You'll really enjoy it. Yeah.
All right, one lap
now. Okay, go ahead, change, Rich. So you have different steps. Go through the motions so you understand where we're working. Guard first. Hand hides that movement. So I would do this. I even bring both hands up to make sure I get their attention here. And then that foot turns in, and that prepares a weapon. And then the weapon's going to be outside. No, see, so you just step like this. That it turned off the weapon. You got to keep the weapon on target as much as possible. Yeah, that's the idea. Now that you open it up like this instead of using the compression muscles. So, yeah, there's a lot of pieces in it. Make it work. And pop. Yeah. Go ahead, keep playing with it. And try a big jump, a huge step at the same time. Now pop. So you. Yeah, see that? You can see how that would start hurting someone. The more you make it one straight line going out, the more the power goes in that person's body. Pop. Wow, you get it. Wow, that's nice muscle control. Wow, that's beautiful. He's going to like it. I can guarantee you'll not take someone out with this one. If they get hit in the stomach with this, they will not want to continue fighting. If they get hit in the pelvic with it, the inside of the leg with it, they won't want to continue fighting. It's such a hard hit. If you hit one time like a big, huge hammer like that, it'll break there. Now, that was back to a karate style kick a little bit. Pop it out. Now, yeah, pop, big, huge leap. You got to cover a little bit, because it's shorter, you do have to cover a little distance. So this is what gives you the distance, is that kind of jump. And I don't pull behind. Like you're trying to pull behind, like a karate, you're trying to turn it into a karate side kick. I would go up, watch me, like this. So I go out, pop. But not one, two, all at once, watch me. Out, watch what happens here. Out, pop, closer. You see, it's a pops, it's all one pop. You gotta turn the foot too. One, two, pop, okay? Cock it up more, compress the muscles, you should feel like a squat feeling. That's the idea. That's close. Pop here. You want to try a few left ones? Turn the body when you're ready. Oh, that's pretty close. You see the power of it? You see that time, but you still aren't perfect. You see how it lost the power this way a little bit? The more you compress it into one line, straight that way, if you can figure out how to do that, that's the most powerful way of doing it. Pop. Go ahead. Yeah, close. That's pretty close, huh? Yeah, you have to turn the hips and compress at the same time, huh? Oh, that's pretty close, huh? Yeah, you have to turn the hips and compress at the same time, huh? Bruce Lee would be proud, Fernando. There, it's like a Bruce Lee would be proud. It's like a Chinese guy doing this. And it's not even karate. What's that breath holding? Go, ah, release all the diaphragm. Compression and release, sit up as you scream.
Well, that's not black.
No, it's okay, you're learning. You're learning. You know what? I would lower his left side harder. Yeah. I would lower the target for the left side. Do a couple like that, lower. Hold your, don't hold your prey going, ah, a couple times. Oh, yeah. Look at that. That was good. Do that again. Yeah. Look how nice that all comes together. Oh, beautiful, beautiful, beautiful. Now try the good side again, the right side.
Oh, it's
done. Ah. Yeah, that is, it wobbled out that time a little bit, huh? Did you see how I did it? It wobbled out one?
You gotta, yeah. Pushed it out instead of
yeah.
Kicking it through. Ha! No. Oh, I gotta accept something.
Beautiful. That's pretty good. That's pretty good. That was pretty good. You were getting real consistent on the right side, Fernando. You have more flex on the right hip than the left. I'll hold the breath that time. And you don't turn your back to your opponent.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, give him a little, every time he goes left side, if he does the left side, give him a little lower target. Oh, right's okay. Actually, you know, because the target is like this, the ideal target is probably the guy's abdomen and pelvic area. So unless you hit, put it right at your pelvic area and stretch it out, and then you see if you can take it out at the pelvic. That's where the most damage is going to be done in this kick. Yeah, to gain flexibility and control, I would gradually increase the height of it, so you guys get comfortable higher and higher, and then you get lower is easier then, right? You train higher, but kick lower in combat.
In my part, I think it's easier for me in the doing it just a little bit higher.
Oh, okay.
And over here.
Yeah. That's probably because something you're doing in your, funky in your hips then. But yeah.
No, I'm
loosening it.
I'm done.
Okay, change around with Richie. One more round with Richie. And then.
Good job.
still about a minute left. About halfway.
You guys are getting it pretty good though.